Hello everyone, Emma McAdam here. Today I want to talk about my favorite thing, which is neuroplasticity. This is the ability that our brain has to learn and to grow and to change its physical structure and how it functions based on how we use it. So people often have the misconception that if they experience anxiety or depression, that there's something permanently wrong with them or with their brain. And while mental illness does show up in our biology, we can treat mental illness through a variety of approaches. And when you change how you think, you can actually physically change your brain. So I want to make a series of short videos highlighting neuroplasticity using research and stories. So here goes with neuroplasticity nugget number one. So here's a fascinating study from Northwestern University. In 2014, researchers there were able to find markers in the blood that indicated that a person was depressed. Now, it's believed that depression is a combination of psychological and biological and other factors. But the way that depression is diagnosed is through asking about symptoms. So asking things like, do you feel sad or do you feel hopeless most of the time? So usually the way we diagnose depression is just by asking about the symptoms, not the cause, but what we're seeing in a person's life or in their behaviors. So in this study, what was interesting is that they were able to find 9 RNA markers in the blood of people with depression, and these markers were different from the average person. So here's the coolest part of this. The people with depression did 18 weeks of therapy, cognitive behavioral therapy, right? This is talk therapy. And the ones who benefited from talk therapy, the ones who saw their depression symptoms resolve, they also saw those blood markers change. So simply talking about things in therapy and learning new skills and working through your problems can create physical changes in your blood. How cool is that? Now, this was a limited study, and researchers are still working to develop an accurate physical test of depression. So for now, we still rely on a symptom interview to determine whether or not someone has depression. But my takeaway is that even when mental illness is having biological effects, we can treat mental illness and those biological effects from multiple approaches, right? Medication, exercise, diet, and talk therapy. How we think and how we talk physically changes our brain and our body. I think this gives me a lot of hope. Like, when I learn about neuroplasticity, it gives me hope that I can change my brain and get healthier and happier. Also, I would like to thank BetterHelp for sponsoring this video. They provide professional, affordable online counseling with licensed therapists in your state. So check out the link in the description for 10% off your first month. They offer therapy starting at around $65 a week. So I think this is a really incredible service that they provide, makes therapy more accessible. If you'd like to learn more, just check out the link in the description. Okay, that's it. Let me know in the comments if you'd like to learn more about neuroplasticity. Thank you for watching and take care.